this is how you get the $1 million. Forget about manifesting, go buy lottery tickets, right? I mean, that's kind of what your options are if you're not going to do the other thing. Hello, Transurfer and the Transurfing Curious. My name is Renee Garcia and this is Transurfing TV. And today, it's not about the $1 million, you guys. Oh my God. Sometimes I feel like I'm like, I don't know. I feel like a record is playing towards me. And I get asked so many of the same questions across my social media accounts. And there's like this thing with wanting to have $1 million, you know? And it's, I don't even know where to start. I mean, okay, here's the thing. $1 million would be awesome, right? I'm actually working towards $1 million myself and I'm doing pretty good, but it's not about the $1 million for me. It's not even actually one of my goals. It's not an intention. I'm not focused on it. I have a very soft idea of what would help me to feel financially secure, but it's my goals that are what's valuable to me. Those are my intentions. Those are the things that I put my energy and focus towards that I have power, real power in accomplishing or obtaining because I have heart and mind coordination over them. That's the key. I have heart and mind coordination over them. I don't think the human being feels heart and mind coordination over $1 million. The mind definitely does, right? The mind's like, oh, fuck yeah, that's going to be great. But the heart doesn't understand money. The heart doesn't give a rip about money. What the heart feels and knows and wants are the things like meaning and purpose and feeling satisfied with yourself. And yes, I guess theoretically $1 million could make you feel satisfied with yourself, but what happens after $1 million? What happens after you get $1 million? So this is for the people that are still coming to this modality asking, where's $1 million or how do I get $1 million? I actually had someone message me asking me how they could manifest $1 million in one day. I want to see it tomorrow. And I'm just like, oh my God, you're missing the whole of Transurfing. Like you're just not getting it. You can absolutely have $1 million, but when you are attached to a goal such as $1 million without any way to really facilitate it, right? A lot of people asking me this question don't have the way to come up with $1 million, but they're focused on $1 million and trying to materialize that rather than trying to materialize the way that the $1 million just comes naturally, right? So this is a big, juicy topic, and I was talking about it the other day with Jeremiah Johnson. We had an in-depth conversation about the whole $1 million thing, and we were just laughing because it's like, okay, so a lot of people come to this modality with desires, right? They desire something and they're hoping that reality Transurfing is going to help them connect to their desires. Usually this is people coming to reality Transurfing still rocking that inner intention. You know, you can, I could talk about things till I'm blue in the face about Transurfing, the value in heart and mind coordination, finding purpose, finding something that's specifically intended for you and hitting it like a hammer just over and over and over and over and over. And then at the end, they'll be like, yeah, but I want that $1 million. How do I get $1 million? So if you are one of those people that are still feeling desire for $1 million and feeling as though your reality is lacking $1 million. I hate to break it to you, but unless you take absolutely extreme action and completely dive in to something in some way that is going to create $1 million, you're not going to materialize it. You are never going to have that $1 million, and you will simply have importance over that $1 million your entire life. And I know that sounds a little bit harsh, but what I'm doing is how you get $1 million, right? What people like Tony Robbins or Elon Musk or people that are really becoming a master at their craft, this and making this the intention and making this the focal point and making this the thing that you fuel with your meta power. This is how you get $1 million. Forget about manifesting, go buy lottery tickets, right? I mean, that's kind of what your options are if you're not going to do the other thing. Now, I know that's a little harsh, and I'm sorry to come at y'all like that, but the $1 million thing is getting ridiculous, you guys. It really is. So it's not about the $1 million. Before I get started, remember to subscribe, like, comment. Join me on the Facebook group. I'm on there. I'm talking about this stuff, y'all. International Transurfing Institute Facebook group, reality_transurfing for Instagram. And I do actually have a money course, my Mo Money course on Teachable Reality 2.0, but it's really not a course about money. I mean, it is a course about money. You will definitely make more money if you follow that stuff, but it is about getting to this version of you and really pulling money from a source of internal brilliance that you have, that you can create money if you want to, but it's not going to be created outside of you. It is created inside of you first, and it absolutely is. So the first quote that I want to give you all, Coco Chanel, wow, she nailed it. There are people who have money and there are people who are rich. And that is in fact the truth. I probably have more money now than I did when I was in this mode. And I'm going to break it down my experience, because I actually, you know, for those of you that don't know, and I haven't really talked very openly about it, but I actually lived, you know, a $1 billion lifestyle for a number of years of my life. And I never felt poor in my life, and it was absolute hell. So I'm going to tell you my experience with that. And then I'm going to tell you this part of my experience, my transurfing relationship with money, and how I'm so much happier, and money doesn't even really, I'm not even really thinking about it anymore. This was my poverty mentality. This is my transurfing mentality. This is me transcending poverty mentality. So another quote, Mo Money, Mo Problems, Notorious B.I.G. So, okay, here's the thing with that quote. Mo money does not necessarily mean mo problems, but if you're going after mo money in this way, it definitely does mean mo problems. So it's about checking yourself before wrecking yourself, because just going after the money is bad for your health, right? Oh God. Okay, so money mindset. I'm going to talk briefly on the hell that I experienced with taking my poverty mentality into a position of wealth. I grew up very, very poor. I wore secondhand clothes. I was made fun of in school because I was always, you know, looking different. I never had money to do anything. People called me poor. People made fun of me. And I went into adulthood not knowing how to get myself out of feeling poor. So what I decided to do was I decided to make money, and I was going to make a lot of money. And I found a profession, my primary business, that there was definitely opportunity. It was very lucrative. If I really did it well, it could be very, very lucrative. And I saw that, and I seized that opportunity. Now, what happened was I went about that endeavor with a ton of inner intention, and my sole focus in life became about making money. And I didn't quantify how much I wanted to make. I just was like this hamster on a wheel chasing that carrot, never quite catching it. More money was never enough. I was constantly insecure with myself because I was throwing myself into some very high echelon groups, but here I was bringing my poverty mentality, and it was really like a mind fuck, and I was constantly comparing myself and thinking, okay, well, I gotta get more. Well, that if I just get more, then that will solve that problem, right? And I kept telling myself that, just get more and then it will solve that problem. But as I got more, then there was another problem. There was somebody else to compare myself to. So I could never quite get there, and it was maddening, and it was depressing, and it was filled with anxiety. And it was hell. It was absolutely hell. I was constantly in fear of losing what I had, right? I had no concept of advantage. I had no concept of my world's taking care of me. I was in constant fear that something was going to happen. I was one bad deal away from the trailer park, right? So I went after false goals. I would see something and be like, okay, that's my next goal. I'm going to get that and I'm going to do that. And created all these false goals that took a huge amount of energy and emotional resources and propping up and really compromising myself. Self-care, self-love out the freaking window. I was hard on myself. I was hard on others. I had extremely low self-esteem. And I, again, focused on money, status, lifestyle, what others thought of me. And I was doing this all from a place of inner intention. So I had a bunch of cool stuff, not to brag, but I had a bunch of cool stuff. I had fancy $100,000 BMW. I had a beautiful 42-foot sailing yacht in Marina Del Rey, luxury apartment. I had a boyfriend that had a 70-foot yacht. He had a private jet. I mean, it was a slamming lifestyle. It was awesome, except for the fact that it fucking sucked, right? So, okay, I'm so happy that I can say that now. I'm really so happy that I can say that now. Okay, so had I approached that life from the transurfing modality, things would have played out much differently. My importance surrounding money, my understanding that, yeah, it's great to wake up in the morning with money, but without that purpose, without that heart and mind coordination, life is just going to continue to be, you know, you're living in your outer screen, right? You're living in your outer screen, concerned with the status and the lifestyle and the social stuff and all that. And you're not really in a place where you're creative, having purpose, finding meaning with yourself and your time and all that kind of stuff. So what I would like to say is this. I know that before I get into this in a moment, I know that money definitely helps. And a lot of people are really challenged right now because of no income stream or, you know, you lost your job because of COVID, your business closed, your business failed. Lots of people message me about stuff like that. And I totally get that. I feel personally the people that are really devastated and wrecked by losing or not having are the people that were in this sort of money mindset when the loss or disruption in income stream occurred, right? So now, and I teach this in my money course, if this is you and if you're really challenged, you want that $1 million, or you just at least want to provide for yourself, what I teach in my Mo Money course is that it's about, so imagine that your old financial reality is like a wave, right? And your money came in like a wave. That wave has gone out. The tide's gone out, right? And your little boat's sitting on the sand and you got no water. So now is your time to switch boats, right? Now is your time maybe to take your boat up shore and work on it a little bit before you get back into the water or something else, right? Just to sit there and not do anything in your boat waiting for the tide to come back in. If it does, you're probably just going to be going back into this mode. So it's really about redefining yourself so your and evolving yourself so your income stream can, in fact, become healthier, right? So, okay, this was me suffering poverty mentality, enough was never enough, fear of loss, false goals, inner intention, insecurities of self, comparing to others, all that bullshit. Okay, this is me with true joy because I'm in active heart and mind coordination every day. I don't have to think about money anymore. I am released. I have released myself from the importance of money. I have purpose. I have what I need, nothing more, nothing less. Exactly what I need today, and it is enough because my world takes care of me. I know that outer intention is going to provide me with everything I need. All I need to do is work my center screen creativity mode. That's all I need to do. Outer intention will bring in the money. Outer intention will bring in the opportunities for income, additional income stream, all that kind of stuff. I focus on creating my tribe, you people, the people in my life, being happy with the people in my life, expressing love, expressing gratitude. And the number one, hands down, without a doubt, thing that has helped me in not only getting out of this mode, but getting into this place where it's not about the $1 million, but money comes to me easily and in abundance, is me focusing intently on my levels of self-love and self-care. I am so different today than who I was 10 years ago. If you guys saw the difference in my demeanor, my mindset, my energy level, my thoughts, you would see that I have transurfed myself to another version of reality where I am living in joy, heart and mind coordination. Money comes to me easily. I'm not tripping the fuck out on a daily basis over money. I really don't even care anymore. And this is where lowering the levels of importance about money definitely have helped me to have more of it. My negative slide about money is that something goes wrong in my life, whatever it is. I lose the wealth that I've accumulated. I lose my investments. I lose my house. And I need to move into a little single room studio apartment with a bed and a little table and a little kitchenette. And that's it, and no car. And when I play this negative slide in my head, I'm like, oh my God. I would actually be happy doing that. I would have my little room. I'd have my transurfing books. I would have my light ring so I could film my videos. And I would just live very, very simplistically. I'm totally okay with that. So it was coming to this modality, and I'll admit I didn't come to this modality with the idea that it was gonna connect me to $1 million. I had already, this version of me was already broken. I didn't want to deal with anything about money anymore because it had caused me so many problems, right? Notorious B.I.G. said it correct. It caused me so many problems. I was interested in growing the wealth of who Renee was as a person, how Renee is going to make an impact, how Renee is going to help other people. I was interested in finding something that's specifically intended for me that I could be really, really, really good at and feel happy doing. And when I tell people when they come to me with the $1 million thing, I'm like, dude, listen, you get the $1 million, you probably go act like an idiot and spend 500,000 of it real quick, buy a fancy car, you know, go on a couple of vacations. So you got $500,000 left. You come back home after you've went and ate and drank and shopped and bought fancy crap. And what are you left with after that, right? What are you left with after that? It's not about the $1 million. It's about who do you want to be? Who do you want to be? What type of person do you want to become? Not just a wealthy person, right? Because remember, there are people who have money and there are people who are rich. This was me with money, boyfriend, jet, yacht, yachts, plural, fancy apartment, all that crap. This is me with wealth. This is me rich. This is me rich. I'm rich in life. I'm rich in character. I'm rich in intentions. This is where it's at. So, are you still focused on $1 million? And what do you need to do to cycle up out of that shit? I'm on one today, guys. How can you get a little bit more over here? And for those of you that are still like, I want the money, I want the money, I want the money, I have a video coming out titled Going After a False Goal or Achieving a False Goal. And that might be for you. It's not going to be an easy ride and it's not going to be a fun one, but I'll give you a few tips if you still just want that $1 million. Or you can drop importance on the $1 million and you can start applying your action and your thoughts to becoming the fullest, best version of yourself. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, join us on Facebook and Instagram. And thank you so much for watching, everyone. Bye.